My name is Lisa Oteri. I am the owner of Oteri's Italian Bakery located in Philadelphia. My great-grandfather started the bakery in 1904. I took the bakery over 8 years ago when my father had passed away.
Before Buddy came, the problems we were running into was a lot with, like, Lisa's father passed away. You know, a lot of people, they just automatically, because that one person's not there anymore, things don't taste the same. But really, it is the same.
It was really important that we were able to let people know that this bakery was still Oteri's bakery and still owned by Oteri's.
Buddy, how you doing?
Hi, how are you?
Hi, welcome to Oteri's.
Well, when we heard Buddy was coming, the first reaction I had was, I better not come in here and give me a hard time about our product, telling us that our product is not as good as his. I was under the impression when he walked in that he wouldn't find anything wrong with anything.
He's probably looking for something not good. That could take a long time.
When Buddy first came out, he was walking around or tasting the product and saying what he didn't like.
I think it's a little stale. I think they were underbaked, oversweet. The bad news is that I was really disappointed by most of what I tasted here today.
It hurt. I'm thinking to myself, we've been in business since 1904. It can't be that bad. Knowing we've been in business longer than him, it was a little difficult taking his criticism, but sometimes that's what you need. You do want to get better, and you got to take that criticism to get better.
Some of the stuff that he told us, I agreed with. You know, it was about the menu, which I was cool with. But when he started, you know, kind of ripping into the cannolis, I just didn't like it. You know what I mean?
I'd be more than glad to put mine up against yours.
Do a blind taste test?
Blind taste test.
Oh. You and me are both going to make our cannoli cream side by side. I had my shells brought in from Hoboken. We're gonna fill up some cannolis and let the people taste.
Sounds good.
All right, deal.
The cannoli challenge was fun. I actually thought we would win. I really did. I thought there would be no doubt that we would win.
Well, I gotta give it to you, Buddy. You won.
I was surprised. I was really, really surprised. My heart did sink to my stomach. We're known for our cannolis. People come in here tell us all the time how great the cannolis are. We did switch over, we tried his cannolis, but our customers are used to Oteri's cannolis. They're very similar, the shells are almost the same. His cream has a little cheesier, ours is a little sweeter, and I think the people were used to that sweetness.
The one thing that we did, we wound up going back to, was our cannoli, because after said and done, a few weeks went by and people came in and said it just doesn't taste the same.
On a new menu that Buddy has, they definitely like the lobster tails. The lobster tails we were buying. Now we make Buddy's lobster tails, and they are going like crazy. Buddy had given us his tiramisu recipe, and it's absolutely delicious. I must say, probably once a week, I at least eat a piece of that. We also started thinking about making other things. We started making a chocolate hazelnut cake. People come in, it's not always the same old thing. Every week we'll have a special, something different.
You guys got the nicest sign in North Philly.
It's beautiful.
And we painted everything red.
When I saw the sign, when I saw the color, my father's favorite color was red. I never told Buddy that my father's favorite color was red. And when I walked in the bakery and saw the red, I felt like it was coming from somewhere else too.
By them putting those gold strips in the windows and everything, it was just all vintage Tom. You know, that was the amazing part of it. It's like they knew Tom when they put all that stuff in the store.
Buddy putting the pictures on the walls was a great idea. People come in and they feel a part of this family.
I was impressed. I thought maybe, you know, he didn't have the experience or the know-how that he really does have, and he does. He has a lot of experience. He's been doing it for a long time.
It was great working with Buddy. It was almost like working with another family member. Buddy and I share the same story. His father had passed, my father had passed. Now he's carrying on his family bakery and I'm carrying on my family bakery. Businesses are lucky to last 5 years. Not five generations.
So if you can get this longevity going where you can stay open for generations and generations, that's something special.
Lisa's kind of like captain of the ship now, but it's still dear to everybody in the family. So it's really cool to see it just expand. If it does good, it just keeps the memory of Tom alive.